A year and a half after Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia, Mohammed bin Salman first announced his ambitious plans to build a linear city, he has now revealed the first glimpses of what the city will look like. In his bid to steer his country away from the dependence on revenue from crude oil reserves, the Crown Prince has set himself on a path that requires him to do something so outlandish that the world would want to come and see it. He probably recognizes that building the tallest structure in the world does not cut ice with many people. Instead, he is making a city with skyscrapers taller than the Empire State Building and extends linearly for 105 miles, connecting the country's west coast with the east. The line is being designed to put humans first in the pecking order of urban planning and strip off the need for roads to move cars and buses around. Transit within the city is through a high-speed underground rail line that can take you from one end of the city to the other in 20 minutes, while everything else you may need is expected to be a few minutes' walk away from you. The city can accommodate 9 million people, but only uses an area of 13 square miles, which has not been seen in a conventional city. The power demand of the town will be 100% met by renewable sources, while 95% of the project land will be preserved. Calling it urban gravity urbanism, the project design vertically layers the city's buildings so that people can move up, down, or across instead of traveling for miles. Therefore, everything is just a 5-minute walk away, whether it is a public park, office workspace, or school. The construction of the project will use digital designs and industrial-scale construction to pace up the building of the city, while an outer mirror facade is meant for the construction to blend into its environment. The use of vertical farming and autonomous bots to harvest and transport the food to community kitchens, as well as a subscription fee from residents to use them. There was also a mention of a sports stadium built 1,000 feet above the ground and the issue of how the project could disrupt the migration of birds as well as snatch lands away from the tribes of the region. The line is also one of the many other ambitious designs to be undertaken in the NEOM project, such as a manufacturing and innovation city called Oxagon and the first outdoor skiing destination in the Arabian Gulf that will be housed at Trajina, a tourist destination.